We're in a place called the Crucible. Now, I'm not going to tell you why you're here or what happens at the end of this or anything, because it will spoil some of the story. But this is a place that's got seven levels to it. And these guys in this waiting room are people waiting to go in and to be tested. And you're one of these people waiting. Now, we're going to just demo some of the combinations that you can use on magic at the moment. So we'll just go through to the arena. And so we're going to have one fight taking place in here. These arenas get bigger and bigger. Let's just have a look at the magic setup that we've got at the moment. You pull that trigger, Sam. So we've got slow time on level 1, we've got blades on level 2, force push level 3, lightning level 4, and fireball level 5. Now what you're going to see is that to get to this that level 5 slot, it takes some time to do. And that means we can use our magic to keep creatures away from us while we build up those big spells, because those top level spells are nuclear. So, as you can see, the first thing that Sam's done is slow down a time. That's going to give him the time to just get himself in the right position. Now he's using the surround spell called Blades. He's now using Force Push to smash that one beetle. These are fairly low order creatures. He's switching to Gun there again to push them back. Notice how everything's pushed away from him at the moment. And then he's just able to build up to that level 4 spell. In comes in the next wave, and this time let's try and get to level 5. Slow down time again, move out of the way of the creatures, and then trying to get up to this level 5 spell. You get triple the damage if you're hit while you're charging up a spell. That's the problem you've got. So it's tempting to think you can just build up a level 5 and just smash everything, but what a single hit at level 5, look how that health bar went down there. Oh, and he just got a beetle on his head just at the last moment, keeping it away. Now, what I would do, what we'll do is, he's just, unfortunately, just fell to the ground, had to use a resurrection potion. What I would do is I change the combination at this moment and use a spell called either Chaos. Let's do that now. Go into the spell selector. And we'll now change the low order spell. So we'll either use Chaos or we'll use Raise Dead. Which one are you going to use, Sam? Use Raise Dead.
Have you got it?
Or maybe you haven't got it. Or Chaos will do, fine. So we'll just change the low order spell, the last two low order spell slots. Go back in there and do that combat again and see how it differs. So now he can just tap the button and that will just confuse the enemies just to give them enough time to run away. Again, you might think about putting Chaos on the top level spells. If you get a higher order Chaos spell, then these creatures will actually fight for you again. So that all that combination that's there really gives people a sense of being in control of the combat. And look at all this experience that's coming up here. All of those orbs are, remember, you get this something called the combat multiplier onto any combat that you get, so you get varying amounts of experiences there. So you got a fair amount of experience, and in the Crucible, the more exciting your battles, the more excitement multiplier you get down in the bottom right hand corner. You can get lots of gold from doing the Crucible. You can also get more of a score. I won't tell you what the score does for you in the Crucible, but it is pretty important.